Good morning. Did you sleep so good?
Renny, you slept on.
Yeah! Good morning! Good morning!
Let's change your bum. Who's ready for pancakes?
Okay. Banana pancakes.
Oh, please. The best kind.
Bring my sister back! Whoosh, whoosh.
Dada, you say dada?
She's dancing.
You make me laugh. You make me laugh.
I love you too, Mama. I don't know if you can hear them laughing in the other room right now. I will happy dance for this bread every morning. I can't even tell you how good it is. It is the Trader Joe's cinnamon roll bread. And I love cinnamon raisin bread, I think it's called. But I saw this at Trader Joe's and thank God I did. It's a little bit sweetened, but it's really not too much. Like, it's not sugary or anything. I eat it on its own. I usually put it in like the toaster for a few minutes and just get it a little bit toasty. So good. You can add a little bit of butter to it if you want it a little bit more sweet and less savory, but it's just so good. I hope you can't hear the Luke Combs record too much right now, so I'm gonna get copyrighted. Having just a fun slow morning right now, and I wanted this video to be a realistic self-care day. Every day I try to do something for my own self-care and overall wellness, but today I'm gonna try to be more intentional, do a few things that really fill my cup, and honestly, this bread is a good start. I am just feeling really happy today, really grateful. The sun is out, birds are chirping. It is like going to be 45 degrees and blue skies. The girls are happy. They have had such a good morning. We had pancakes. And also, I didn't even mention my new camera. Kind of getting used to maneuvering it around my house for vlogging. It's bigger than my old camera, but it's so much better. It's a wide lens. I did get a new lens in addition to the camera because I just wanted my vlogs to be a little bit better and I wanted to be able to capture more. And we're doing so many fun things this summer and I want to be able to just savor everything, and I feel like having a wider lens is a great way to do that. I can link the vlog camera that I got down below. It is pricey. I have been waiting honestly for like over a year to invest in this camera and this lens. I've been saving and I wanted to just feel like I deserved it and I felt like it was time. A lot of you have reached out that are kind of thinking about starting your own channel and documenting your life and moments, and I would just say you can start vlogging using your iPhone. When I first started my YouTube channel, please don't go back and watch those videos. It was all on my iPhone. I just was passionate about wanting to film and document and share, and I didn't care that I didn't have a great upgraded camera. So I started with my iPhone, and then I used the Canon G7X for a long time, which is a great vlog camera. It's compact. I've been using that for years now. You don't need to invest in a crazy big bulky camera at first. It's all about the content, and then you can upgrade the quality as you grow your channel. I also did shower this morning and did a hair mask, so that was a little self-care time. I ended up waking up 30 minutes before the girls got up to shower and have enough time to do that. I feel like most days Jonathan and I just try to like squeeze in our shower in the morning when the girls have settled and one of us can just kind of keep an eye on them, but this morning I wanted to take a little bit more time for me. I did my self tan routine last night, so I wanted to like scrub that off. For now, I want a ginger shot. You hear them giggling? Actually, I'm going rogue and doing a turmeric shot today. You know I love the Trader Joe's ginger and turmeric shots. This one has turmeric, coconut water, lemon juices, and black pepper. Gotta be good to our bodies. Anyways, what else? My mother is coming over to spend the day with us today. We're going to see my grandmother. We're gonna get lunch over there with my dad. Low-key, pretty realistic in the sense that this is just a window into what a normal day looks like for us. Can you see a little glimpse back here? If you've been here for a while, you know how big of a deal the situation is. Our table came yesterday. You guys, how did I not like start with this?
I absolutely love her. This is the Anton table from West Elm. And I am obsessed. Some of this looks kind of crazy right now because I gotta figure out the decor in the center. I got all these tea light candles and I did get like formal tea light holders that are coming in today just as like decor. And when we have company and when Jonathan and I have dinner, we'll light the candles. I think it'll be a nice ambiance, but oh my God, I love it so much. It is an 8-seater table. We wanted a very big table just for our growing family. We host Christmas every year. I just wanted a big table for lots of guests, hopefully over time. These chairs are the vibe I'm going for. I didn't want to invest a ton of money in chairs because I figure I needed to like feel it out, see what I liked with the table. So these chairs I love, but I don't know if I will have them forever, but they are so cute for now. I love these chairs from Target. It's like a boucle material with the wood finish, so. Yep, this is her. Check her out from different angles. Was it worth like a 5-month wait? I don't know, but I love the design of this table. To me, it looks like an art piece. Like, I just love it so much, and the quality is incredible. It's definitely worth it, but not worth the time we waited. West Elm, not worth that. You two chatty Cathy's in here. How did you get the penguin? Are you sharing? Gentle. Okay, need to figure out what to have the girls wear. We are in a transitional period. I wanted to show this to be realistic because our nursery really usually looks so clean, but right now I am switching out old clothes that don't fit. We just had their baptism, so these are from literally the 90s from Jonathan and my baptism. We're switching out like things they don't use anymore, like all the stuff needs to be packed, moved downstairs, and it just looks crazy, but this is normal. This is life. We have so many hangers and we don't have a ton of clothes right now because they're in such a like in-between age. I don't want to buy a ton of like wintry 9-month clothes because they're growing out of that and spring is coming, so we're just trying to like use what we have, not be wasteful, and wait like another month before buying the 12-month age mark. So anyways, I do have these cute little sweaters. I think I'm gonna put them in for today with some pants. Print is so cute. I feel like that'll look adorable. We've also moved to changing them on the ground, no longer in the changing station, because like diapers will still do up here because they have an attention span of like 1 to 2 minutes before they start squirming around, so we can get a diaper change in. But clothes, we literally have to wrestle them, and if you know, you know. So we have moved to changing on the ground. Hello! It's ready to be changed. I'm trying to think of what pants to do. I'm thinking these pants will be cute. I feel like that's kind of our best option. So,
I'm with it.
All right. Yeah. Okay.
Jump.
They are so close to crawling.
You got wires crossed today.
No.
Sweater gang. It's sweater season.
They're also at the age where when we put them down, they just want to be hugged and picked up again. And we give hugs. Thank you. I love your hugs.
Say hi, Nanny.
Okay, so I just started to put some makeup on, which is a rarity. I don't often do that, but it always makes me feel better when I just put myself together a little bit. I have a literal like 5-minute makeup routine right now that's all products from drugstores. It's a look that's super minimal. I just used the CC Plus Nude Glow Color Correcting Skin Tint. It's literally just like light foundation basically that gives you a little bit of a tan, like it has a skin tint to it, but it's super light and easy to put on. It's light coverage and it's not really heavy and bad for your skin. So you can get this again at Target, drugstores, Walgreens, whatever. It's by IT Cosmetics. And then I use the L'Oreal True Match Concealer just to cover my blemishes. I always put a little bit around my nose because I get red around my nose. And I like this to just even it out. And that's it on my skin. And then I always do some bronzer on my cheekbones and around my face. And I kind of do it in a way that contours myself, but it's so easy. And I know when I hear contour, I'm like, oh my gosh, that sounds overwhelming. I can't do that to my skin, but it's so easy. This is the Maybelline Fit Me Bronzing Stick, and I have the shade Coconut. It's like 355. Do this around here. And I do like to contour my nose a little bit. I just recently started doing it and I think it's fun. I like my cheekbones to look a little snatched, so I just do it like this. Just blend it in. My nose, I just go in on the sides. I use different products every day. This is just to show you that I have some products that I really love that are super affordable. And this is not drugstore technically, but you can get blush anywhere. Not everybody even likes blush, but I am gonna just use a little bit of a blush balm stick here from Merit. As long as you just find a color that works with your skin, most blushes are pretty good. I do like the balm kind because I think it stays on longer than a powder, and I do put it right under my eyes to make it look more natural. I always like to use a finishing spray. This is by NYX. And lastly is eyes. Most of the time I do a little bit of liquid liner on top of my eyes just to brighten them a little bit. I just picked up a new Stila liquid eyeliner stick from Target. This is the dual-ended waterproof liquid eyeliner in the intense black color. I do like a brown liner every now and then, but for the most part I always get like intense black or like darkest shade of black because it just, again, really brightens my eyes in a way that I like. The L'Oreal Bambi Eye Mascara. I have a few different mascara options, some from drugstores, some from Sephora. I really like this one for daytime. And that's really it for my makeup. I am just gonna finish with this Soap and Glory Ultra Smoothing Lip Oil. I've had forever. I love a basic lip oil. You don't really need chapstick or like these crazy lip glosses. Like, lip oils are so good for your lips. They make them look glossy, and the oils are really like nourishing for your lips. So, and yeah, that's what they look like. So this is the finished product. I'm gonna put my hair up. I think I really should be a little bit more quiet. I just booked an appointment with my best friend in May to do a little glow up for summer. I think I want to like lighten the bottom of my hair, chop a good amount of it off because it's just like long and dead right now. All of my little postpartum baby hairs around my face make it so hard to wear my hair up sometimes. Cracks me up. So wild how much our body changes after we give birth to these little humans. Looks kind of crazy, but I cannot have my hair all down being a mom. Like, it just needs to be up and off. The girls are at such an age where they grab my hair constantly. I mean, they've been doing that literally since they were 3 months, but I can never wear it all down. I'll just go with this look for now. Okay, let's go bother my mom. Look at you in your pigtail. You look so cute.
It's not a great hair day, so the hat went on.
I like it.
Nice.
Isn't that nice?
Cheers.
Self-care, we need our coffee.
Yes. How do you self-care?
By taking moments for myself, thinking about good things I have in life and positive thoughts and breathing in and breathing out.
Do you do that every day, you think?
Yeah, I do.
Really?
I do. Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah. I started reading that book, Miracle Morning.
Oh, yeah.
So that's helped me to just take some moments to do some self-care.
That's a good book. I can link that one down below. It's, I feel like a lot of people like that book.
It's a really good book. And I read it at my own leisure. It's not something that I just read straight through. One thing that I really got out of it, that it tells you to wake up an hour. Try to wake up an hour before your day starts. And just take that hour to do whatever you feel good.
It's like you time.
You time. And whether you want to exercise, meditate, take 10 minutes, 15 minutes, any amount of time that you need just to get your day going. And it helps. It helps. I take some mornings and I sit on the floor, cross my feet, and just breathe in and breathe out for 10 minutes.
I love that.
Or I'll just stand up tall and stretch for 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Just take a few moments for yourself and start your day.
That's so good.
And go for an exercise.
This was not planned. I didn't even tell you I was doing.
No, you didn't. And there's another book, 10%
Happier.
10% Happier. 10%
Happier. Is that the one your boss gave you?
Yeah, she gave me both those books.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yes. Yeah.
Noted. Read those books if you need some like reminders. And that's such a good way that you put it, because I feel like a lot of people get books and feel overwhelmed, like, I have to read this right now, I have to read it in 1 day, 2 days. Like, don't put that pressure on yourself. You read a few pages a night and it makes you feel good, and then you put it down.
It's that type of book that you can do. Or you can read the whole book if you wanted to, and then refer back to it.
I just feel like right now, everyone, I don't know if it's just social media and everyone talking about the books they're reading, but it feels like people read books in like a day, and it's like, how many books can I read in a year? It overwhelms me. Pressure. I love the idea of, no, a few pages a day is fine. Because not everybody has time to read. Like, if I start reading at night now, I just fall right asleep because I'm so tired.
And that's what happens to me.
The last sip of coffee is like
the best,
but also so sad. It's over.
So another part of my routine that I'm trying to get back into is incorporating fiber and collagen into my diet in the mornings. Before I was pregnant, I had collagen all the time. I think the benefits are so important. But when I was getting into that stage of my life, I kind of took a break from all supplements. You don't have to, but I just chose to. And now that wellness is more of a priority for me, again, I'm trying to get back into it. So something else that I try to do every day. So excited. I'm gonna have my mom try this as well. So this is Bellway Super Fiber and Collagen and Bellway Super Fiber and Fruit Powder. And I strongly believe that gut health is so important, and we've talked about this, I've talked about it in so many videos. Your gut affects your whole body. It affects your immune system, your digestive system. It eventually can trickle out and affect your skin, your nails, your hair. Like, things that go wrong in your gut can trigger so many other ailments in your body. I like incorporating things into my diet that help my gut health, and so fiber definitely does that. And it's made with real fruit, no added sugars or preservatives, any of that. It tastes like strawberry lemonade. It is all natural, vegan, paleo friendly. It's gluten free and again has no sugar, which we love. Bellway really sold me when I discovered that the fiber is psyllium husk, and I actually took psyllium husk. Remember when I was training for the marathon? That was like my favorite thing to consume through that process, because I was trying to be so good to my body, which I should be at all times, but when you're training, it reminds you that you need to be doing the best things for your body. And I was taking psyllium husk constantly to get that fiber, to nourish my body. That was the best I felt. I feel like it regulated me. It's so good for your digestive system. There's a ton of benefits, but if you are having issues with digestion, which a lot of people do, psyllium husk is the way to go. I like taking this in the morning specifically because it does help to curb your hunger a little bit, so it helps you to feel full. I like taking this right when I wake up with the girls in the morning at 7 when I don't want to have my breakfast yet, but I want something to like hold me over and wake me up. So it's a good way to just start your day. You can take it whenever though, and you can take it like 2 times a day. Just make your own little cocktail like we're about to do.
And water, you can just mix it.
Yeah, you just mix it with water. Another benefit is that fiber helps to detoxify your system to help prevent breakouts, which I didn't even know. Hyaluronic acid that's in these products as well help to increase skin elasticity, which makes your skin look more youthful. It helps to decrease wrinkle appearance. You can shop Bellway at the link down below in the description. They have a ton of different options and bundles that you can shop. They have fiber and greens. They have vegan capsules, so if you prefer to get your nutrients in capsule form and not powder, you can get that too. It's a nice water, like, experience. You can have a drink. Blends
not
good.
Clumpy. I like that.
Not clumpy.
It smells good, so. I like it.
You like it?
It's smooth. It's very good.
Amazing.
Very good.
Try this one now. This is a real reaction, people. It wouldn't steer you wrong. Raspberry lemon.
Okay, yep.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
And that one doesn't have the collagen in it.
It's very good.
Heard it here first. Yay, well, cheers.
Cheers.
Okay, check it out down at the link below.
Seriously, so obsessed with this camera. I love how much it captures. Before, I feel like my old camera got like this much in the frame, but this lens is just iconic. We are about to pack the girls up. They're finishing up their nap now. I'm gonna wake them up, give them a bottle, and head to my grandmother's house. We're going to bring her lunch. We've been trying to get over there as much as possible. It's been too cold for her to really get out, so we bring the girls there when we can. She loves seeing them, and it just makes her day. That's a good reminder that self-care can also come in the form of calling your grandmother and keeping up with her. If you are lucky enough to have grandparents in your life, they are just so, so special. I love seeing the relationship that's already being built between my daughters and their grandparents, and I have even more appreciation for my Nana.
Is that true? Is that true? Hey, ready?
Hello.
Oh, it's not bad. Oh. Haircut time.
Give her a mohawk.
I know, she just didn't
buzz. Oh no. What do you think about that, Nana? Should we buzz it all off?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Curious George, that's a classic.
That's what my brother used to have big ears.
The papa or the little monkey?
They kind of look the same. I showed these in a Trader Joe's haul I did recently, but I'm so obsessed with these. I forget what they're called. Jonathan, what are these baby breaths called again? I'm pretty sure they're called unicorn baby breaths. Just like brighten up the whole space. I don't think it was rainbow. I'm like pretty confident it's unicorn, but can confirm at a later time. Who's up from a nap? Oh, someone's still sleeping. They're just so cute.
Yeah, this one's happy.
Hello. Who woke up from her nap a little too early? Are you going to the nanny salon?
Gotta get the other hand.
You getting a manicure?
Some nail polish on those nails.
No. We do have non-toxic nail polish that you can do if you want. I think it's in my diaper bag.
Let me have your other hand. Let me have your other hand. Oh, watch your forehead. Watch your forehead.
I did want to show these little tea lights that I mentioned earlier. They just came in. I love them so much. I can't wait to light them tonight. Jonathan and I are gonna have a nice little date night. The girlies are going to have lunch. They're doing tomatoes today, and this is quinoa mixed with mashed chickpeas and a little bit of lemon. They really like it. So it's funny, the other night we gave Ren tomato, and or the other day, and she was up for like an hour after bedtime, like not settling. It seemed like her belly really hurt, so we took a break from the tomatoes because we think maybe the acidity of them hurt her stomach. So we're hoping today she does okay. Maybe it was just like a fluke thing. And I mentioned that the girls do really well with drinking out of their little sippy cups. Actually, these are not sippy cups. They're just training cups, I guess, to teach them how to drink. And they do really well with them. We have a metal one too, but today we're just going to use this kind. I need a little afternoon snack. I really like this dark chocolate almond pretzel sea salt bark from Trader Joe's because it does give me a little bit of extra energy because of the caffeine in the chocolate, and it's not too sweet, this one, so I really like it.
Eating this kind of reminds me that I used to always give up chocolate for Lent every single year for like over a decade, like 10, 12 years, something like that. Would always give up chocolate. And then last year I was pregnant during Lent, and chocolate was the only thing that made me happy, literally. So I didn't give it up. And then now this year, I just didn't give it up again. So do you guys give up anything for Lent? I try to just be a good person during the season. I just like my chocolate.
Just chilling. Ready? You're already twins, and now you're married! One, two, you better move quick, Mom. Oh, no. I stopped, I fall started.
She's laughing.
One, two, three!
Woo! Look at those girls swinging.
Yay!
Yeah. Who's this? Sienna! Sienna!
Go, girlie!
Good first
park.
Ma'am. Just another day in the life of a twin mama.
Hi, I know. Hello. It's another day.
You look cozy.
You know, bacon is a nice pillow. We got nice. Piglet as backup.
Good, good.
So, we're living life. And Lola Bunny, who's getting all of the kisses from Sienna. Did we have so much fun at the park today?
Say yes.
Did you make some new friends?
They're big swing girls, huh?
They love the swing.
We're gonna have to get them hooked up here in the summer.
I know.
Right out there.
I know, we gotta get Papa to build us some swings, girlfriends. We get foot massages. Normally it's only one foot that's getting massaged because the other hand is on the other foot on the other baby.
Thank you.
is such a battle. And it's not even that they're at an age where it's extremely impossible to like settle them down and get them in their clothes. They're approaching that like it's more of a struggle, but it's really just because you're so tired and you realize it in the 10 minutes it takes to like put them down, and it is just tiring. This is just really necessary. But we went to the park. It was so fun. It was a girl's first time on swings. They loved it. They had so much fun, and it was so crazy, like just walking, getting them out of the car and like walking to the park. I had such a moment where I was like, whoa, I'm a mom. It's the first time, and there was other kids like looking at the girls, and the girls were like interacting with other kids, like looking at them and laughing and smiling. And it just was that first moment where I was like, whoa, we're gonna bring our kids to the park and we are parents. I don't know. They had such a good time. We were there for like 45 minutes, I would say.
Yeah, that's about right.
Right? Mm-hmm. Maybe 30, maybe 45 longer. Minutes longer, yeah. An hour. I don't know. We have no sense of time.
Ooh, good ring.
That was a good ring. I've had don't like 14 these glasses, sips. I just got these glasses in today from West Elm. They are gorgeous. I love them so much. Jonathan has a bone to pick with West Elm because of, need I say more? They do have the best wine glasses, and he broke two of mine, so.
I broke one. I definitely broke one.
We are making gnocchi right now. We're debating if I should make a Caesar salad for us or not. I feel like the gnocchi is gonna be enough. We have some prosciutto that we're having as like an appetizer, so. I feel like the gnocchi will be good, you know?
Homemade M&M's.
Dessert is self-care.
Is this another self-care video?
This is a self-care video, yeah. Uh-huh. But it's like a realistic self-care, I keep saying that, where it's like, I feel like before I was pregnant and had kids, I would do self-care videos and they were so in-depth and I would take full days and just soak up the self-care, and that's just not reasonable as a mom, and that's okay. So this is just realistic.
Little moment self-care.
Little moments. My mom had some really good advice. I wanted to ask you what you do for self-care. What do you do to take time for yourself throughout the day?
I could solve world hunger in the shower.
You could solve world hunger?
Yeah.
That's good. That's more than most of us could do during a shower sesh.
Aww. Do you do have drink coffee? I drink coffee.
Coffee is self-care.
Yeah,
you enjoy your cups of coffee in the morning. You do look forward to your first sip.
I do like cooking dinner.
I feel like that's your time to...
Yeah, because it's all like tasks and stuff. So it's like, I like that. And I like trying new things and perfecting things. And
yeah.
That is fun for me.
And you do a lot for the fam, but you can't do it all, and you gotta check in with yourself. So this is a raw, real reminder that if you or your partner is not doing things to check in with themselves, remind them that they should.
I go to the gym.
Oh, you do go to the gym. You do get your workout in.
Yep.
And you've been doing that much more lately.
Better, yeah.
Yeah. That's self-care, working out. Mm-hmm. I have not gotten back on that train, but I'm glad you have. Anyways, gonna have a nice little night, and I was trying to think of something fun for Jonathan and I to do. We're big on trivia and fun games like that when we have our date nights and like quality time. We try to just play games. A few vlogs ago, I showed that we got Battleship at Target and we played that. Just fun to do intentional things, but I wanted to do a draft.
Like a Mount Rushmore draft?
Yeah, like a Mount Rushmore draft of best parenting moments. Let us sit. I'm gonna sit next to you tonight. Last night I sat across from you, but tonight I wanna be right on next to you. Oh yeah. So we're doing our four favorite parenting moments so far.
Are we doing a snake draft or just back and forth?
What does that mean?
You get first pick.
This is like parenting moments, not like highlights of our life, which is obviously the day they're born and like all that fluff. We're not doing that. This is like best parenting moments.
Yep.
As a parent, in like our short 9 months that this chapter has existed, I think that the baptism day, having them in the church, they were so well behaved, they were so charismatic, and everyone was just soaking them up, and it was their first time seeing so many people. And to me, it was just, we were nervous for it because it was our first time really being around people, and I was like proud of them and just overjoyed at the experience. And so I'm gonna go with the baptism day.
I'm gonna go with the first belly laugh.
I can't pinpoint the first one.
It was in the crib at the old house.
That's when we got it on video.
Yeah, right around there. Yeah.
But just that season of
laughing. Like their first
laughs. Yes. That's so
100%.
Good. I remember the first day, they went a full day without having an episode.
Mm-hmm.
Putting my head down the pillow that night and being like, oh my gosh. And obviously,
could
this be behind us? Yeah. And from that point on, they didn't. Yeah. I think they had like one random one or whatever, but it was such a proud, happy, overjoyed parenting moment.
Yeah, everyone told us they'd grow out of it, and they finally did.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say us finally getting into a routine with sleep training. It made their life better and it made our life better.
Wow, you're thinking of the most obvious ones and I just didn't even think of them. My head goes too deep.
I
overthink. I took a unique route with this game.
You did?
It's like 2 days ago, Sienna started saying mama. She hears us saying mama so much, she's trying to repeat that. Like she wouldn't just randomly start saying ba 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 ba. And even if she would, I'm telling myself it's mama. And in her little cute voice, because it's only Sienna that has really done it so far, in her little cute voice, yeah, it might be like a buh sound, but she's trying to say mama.
That's a good one.
Because everything's been da-da for a month now.
I've told you that. It doesn't really count, though, because it hasn't been, like, directed towards me yet.
Well, I read a thing, and I think it's just trying to make women feel better, because for the most part, babies say da-da first. It's an easier word to say. The study claimed that babies say da-da so much because mama, they identify with as part of, like, them. They think of mama as, like, me and mama are the same person, like we're just so connected that they're obviously going to say dada first because it's an external thing, an idea and concept, and so mama comes after.
Mm.
So I'm choosing to believe that's why I didn't come first.
Moms deserve it all.
Okay, your next one.
I mean, I'll take the easy route and say the dada. It is nice to hear.
I'm so happy you're saying that because you always suppress it and you're like, they're not saying dada, it's not. They're saying dada. Their first word was dada, and that is...
That's not their first word.
Yes, it is. It will always be... Babe, yes, it
sound
is.
More or less.
They say dada, and they should say dada, because dada does everything for them. Okay, well, I'm going with crawling. It was Ren, very specific example, but she got across the whole playpen, and it was, like, iconic of her.
I think the coolest part with food...
This is your fourth pick?
Yeah. Learning to eat is different because, like, gaining their trust and trusting them is such, like, a cool feeling. Like, knowing that they know what to do. Watching them figure it out. It's, like, the first thing they're learning. Watching them learn how to eat has been, like, awesome.
Yeah, so the whole experience.
Kind of. But
no,
like,
you're supposed to pick specifics.
Well, like, I'm really happy that they love to sit in the chair. Like, we're very lucky that they don't fuss. Like,
no, they love the high chair. What's one of your favorite food to have them love? Peas was a proud moment for me.
I hated peas. It's gotta be sweet potato because they're so good at that. Or pancakes. They've eaten more cauliflower in their life than I have.
They've eaten more most foods. They've eaten more peas than you have. When was the last time you had peas?
On purpose?
Or broccoli?
Chicken, broccoli, and ziti.
The little flakes that you can't flick out. That was fun.
That was fun. Do you think you won?
Do I think I won? Well, I think in my heart, those experiences mean so much to me, so of course I won. Mm. But you hit on the obvious things.
You're saying obvious, like you're, it's like condescending, like it's like...
Honestly, as much as they were basic, I didn't even think of them. That's how you know I overthink everything. Finish our dinner, sit on the couch and watch a movie.
Not a movie.
Oh, we're finishing you.
Mm-hmm.
But anyways, that's all for this video. Thanks for being here, and I will see you in my next one. Cheers.